Hey, Michael Church here with CrawlspaceNinja.com, and today I'm going to talk about air sealing rim joists, why you should do it, why it's important, how to do it, and what BuildingScience.com says about doing it. So stay tuned. This is a bit of a lengthy video, very important stuff. I hope you like it. Thanks. Okay, now rim joists, in case you don't know, they're, if you have a block foundation or a concrete foundation, you've typically got a rim joist, okay? And in a basement or a crawl space, if you look up in, around the edge of the building, you'll have these little pockets where the joists come together. That's called the rim joist. Now, the problem with rim joists is that they're never insulated, or if they are insulated, they'll take a piece of fiberglass and they'll shove in that rim joist to create a thermal barrier. Okay, now here in Tennessee, typically we don't need a thermal barrier in our rim joist, but it has been getting colder in the winter, so we have seen condensation forming on the rim joist because the crawl space will be warm and the outside will be 25, 30 degrees, or even in the teens, and that cold air hits that outside of the building, transfers through the rim joist, hits the warm air in the crawl space, and actually creates condensation. So if you want to help prevent that, it's a great idea to insulate the rim joist. There's a couple different ways to do it. You can, as I said earlier, the easiest, least expensive way is to just get a roll of maybe R19 fiberglass craft batting and just cut it to shape, shove it in there. All right? That's a great way to do it. A little bit better way, if you want to air seal and insulate the rim joist, is to use foam board or spray foam. Now, we have used both. We like the foam board spray foam combination better than just one or the other. Spray foam, the reason why it's good, but if you ever get a leak from the outside and you have to do any repair on the rim joist or you're concerned about the rim joist, it's really hard to get off. So spraying spray foam on there is great. You want to make sure it's thick, though. I think it's 1 inch, 3.2 R value per inch. So if you can imagine, you're going to have, you know, 3 to 4 inches to get a decent R value on that spray foam. Foam board, however, you know, a 2 inch to 2 1/4 inch piece of foam board is already at an R10. Okay, so you could double that up if you wanted to, but typically an R10 in our region is good enough, and there is no, as far as I know, code on what the rim joist insulation would be, because there is no code that you have to have rim joist insulation in East Tennessee. So an R10 with a spray foam around the edge is a great way to prevent thermal transfer and also to stop the airflow up into the house, and I'm going to talk about that here in just a second. Okay, so the engineers at BuildingScience.com, they have written a paper, if you will, about rim joist insulation, and in their words, they call it a critical seal. In other words, they recommend that every home with a crawl space or a basement have the rim joist air sealed and properly insulated. So one of the things you can do to air seal the rim joist yourself is to use a piece of foam board. Now, this is an EPS foam board. There's also what's called XPS, and I'm not going to get into the differences, but basically an EPS foam board is just, it's manufactured differently. As you can see, it's little granules of polystyrene, okay, and the reason why we like this foam board, two reasons. Number one, it has a termite preventative actually built into it, but the second reason is it actually allows moisture to wick through it. It's not as permeable as the XPS foam board, which is either your blue Dow foam board or your pink Owens Corning foam board that you would find at the box stores like Home Depot or Lowe's. As I mentioned before, sometimes there are problems with rim joists leaking water. So if you have a piece of XPS polystyrene on the rim joist as an insulator and you spray foam around it, that moisture is not leaving once it gets trapped. Now, granted, you're not going to have that problem a lot, but if flashing fails, a deck, for example, is a great place for rim joists to have issues, where brick comes up and possibly meets siding. is another place where we've seen issues with rim joists rotting out. But basically, water, if it gets behind whatever your outside building material is, whether it's brick or siding, and gets trapped into that rim joist area, having an EPS foam board like this one will actually allow the moisture to wick through. Now, is it going to prevent wood damage or mold? Probably, I don't know, probably not, but it's going to at least help prolong the wood rot and keep it from happening as quickly as would an XPS foam board, either the blue or the pink kind. So what you do is, whether you have a truss system or studs, you know, the truss is, you know, 2x4s made into a truss, or if you have the studs, which could be a 2x10 or a 2x12 or even a 2x8, you just cut the foam board accordingly, and it would typically be a 16x10 or 12x8. You just cut it. You take that piece of foam board, you put it inside the rim joist, and then you spray foam around the edge to make sure it's air sealed, and you got you a good thermal barrier, because this is an R10, plus you have air sealed that rim joist, okay? So why is it so important to air seal the rim joist? Well, believe it or not, air moves up the walls of your house from the basement or the crawl space. And if you go to buildingscience.com and you type in insulate rim joist, that's all you have to do. There is a paper on there that shows you how important it is to air seal the rim joist. And from what I understand, they're saying it's as important to air seal the rim joist as it is to air seal your attic. So the number one place to invest in air sealing would be your attic, to keep the air transfer up out of the house. But the second most important place would be the rim joist, to keep that air from actually moving up the walls and causing a draft to pull conditioned air out of your house. Now, here's a good tip. It's typically more expensive in most cases, depending on the size of your home, to air seal the attic, because you've already got insulation there, right? Well, you've got to take that insulation out, or you got to move it in order to air seal the top plates and the can lights and all that. So it's kind of a big job to do something like that. We have insulation vacuums that actually remove the insulation and create just a bare floor in the attic, and then we can go through and critical seal or even guarantee seal the floor of the attic. Okay, so if you can't do that on your own and you don't have the money to hire someone to do that at this point, then air sealing the rim joist is a great inexpensive place to start. It's gonna save you money in the long run, because it's not allowing that air from the crawl space or the basement to transfer up the walls. And while you're down there, go ahead and hit all the plumbing and electrical penetrations that are in the subfloor and around the HVAC boots and things like that while you're there, to keep that transfer of air at a minimum at best. So I hope you like this video, and please let me know if you have any questions about air sealing. We've also got another great video about how to install a knee wall, which is another great place to air seal if you've got a larger home with knee walls and you're losing a lot of air into the attic or coming from the attic in the summer into the living space. Be sure to check out that video too. But anyway, I'm Michael Church with CrawlSpaceNinja.com. I hope you liked this video, and if you did like this video, please like the video below. Hope you'll share it, and let me know if you have any questions in our comments and everything down below. Have a great day.